Hey everybody, today we're going to do this 1990s inspired makeup look. This is from a Spice Girls picture that I found on the internet, so hopefully you all like it and keep watching for the tutorial. Alright, so we're going to start by putting on a base. I'm using a Too Faced Shadow Insurance. So I usually just take this on my ring finger and get about that much. So we're going to start with a light colored eyeshadow. I'm using this from a Wet n Wild palette. So it's this color right here. Just a really shimmery peach shade. And I'm going to pick up that with a small eyeshadow brush. And we're going to apply this to the inner half of the eye. So just pat this on. Bring what's left over into the tear duct. And then I'm going to just take this a little bit and blend this part up here. Just so we don't have a line of that color. Even though it's light, you can still see the difference. Okay, so there's that. Next, we're going to start with the dark color. So what I'm going to use is Milani Spice. So it's that one. And it's a really warm brown color, so that's what you're looking for. And I'm going to pick this up with a Q-tip. So now this is the first time I've used it, but it actually is working really well for me. So you still make sure to tap it off so you don't get too much. And we're just going to try to create this kind of shape right on this side. So first we're just going to bring it right here. And then bringing it out. About, let's see, a little more than that. Okay, then you want to bring this, it's not quite half, and you want to kind of start it here and then bring it up at a diagonal, just really slightly. Okay, and now so we can get that point, we need to take a small eyeshadow brush like that, and just using the same color again, we're going to take this kind of on the side of the brush and just create that nice point. And then just fill that top part in a little bit so you get that V shape. And you're just going to fill in all of this as well. Okay, so now that you have that nice shape, we're going to use the same brush and just pick up shadow along the edge of it, like the tip of it, the top part. I don't know how many times I can say that. And then we're going to take this just above the crease and create a nice line. And you're going to take this about 3/4 of the way in. So you don't want this very blended. Just about like that. Now for the highlight part. Now this is where it's definitely got that 90s look to it, as if this didn't show you enough. I'm going to use just a white highlighting color. I'm using Jane White Lies. And just pick it up on any large eyeshadow brush. And so we're going to take this and just really pack it on, especially right on this part of the eyebrow. And then kind of with what's left over, just blend it in over here. Because we already had that light shade, so it's just going to all blend together nicely. So you don't want to worry too much about blending it into this brown right now. Just want to concentrate right under the brow. And then we're going to take a Q-tip, and we're going to just really gently smudge the edge of this line. It's not going to make a whole lot of difference, but it's just going to make it a little smoother looking. It's just going to blend it nicely. About it. What I'm going to do for eyebrows is just fill them in really lightly. My eyebrows are pretty much the shape that they had. It was just pretty natural, but not like overgrown looking in the 90s. So just going to fill mine in and use a little brow gel to keep them in place. And we'll add mascara and then come back for cheeks and lips. Okay, so the eyes are finished, and now for cheeks, I'm going to use I think it's ugly brown color. This is from a MAC Flip For It. So we're going to take this just on a blush brush. It does look like a bronzer. You could probably use a bronzer, but it's just that bronzers tend to be really orangey, and it'd be okay, but it's not exactly what I'm looking for. So for the blush, we're going to pretty much take it on, like, under the cheekbone about and just kind of bring it in just a little bit. So I'll show you what to do. So that's about how you want it. A little more right here. So we're kind of forgetting about the apples. So for my face, like foundation wise, the thing in the 90s was to have a very matte looking face. So what I just did was put on some powder, just loose powder on my face, actually pressed powder. So for lips, always use a lip liner. If you can find one that's really dark, go ahead and use that. If you want to go for that kind of, like, where you can only see the line on the out, if you want to do that, go ahead. I wouldn't recommend it if you wanted to go anywhere and act like a normal person, but whatever. Okay, so I'm just going to use a darker lip liner than my lip and just line the outer part of it with a pretty thick line. Okay, so here's just the lip liner. Then I'm going to put on a brown lipstick. This is MAC Shitaki. So that's what it looks like. And then just for a little more gloss, I'm going to add just like a brown colored lip gloss. Okay, so here's your finished 1990s look. I took this from a Spice Girls picture that I found on the internet. I never really listened to them, maybe one song, but that was about it. But I definitely remember seeing more pictures of other groups or whatever wearing this kind of makeup where it comes out like this. So hopefully you guys like this. It's pretty authentic, like I said. And yeah, so keep requesting and subscribing. Thank you all so much. See you later.